Hi guys, I'm Aiden and this is my endless journey. Endless journey.
Birmingham. Yeah boy! Guess who he is? You're about to find out.
Welcome to Endless Journey
with
Limitless Mind and
Snapback Fitness. We are here joined today with our special guest, Aiden
Massey.
Yeah boy.
Yeah boy.
So yeah, let's kick this right off. We're going to be asking him a few questions about his life, getting to know him a bit better. He has gone through quite a lot in his life and we just want to touch on that in a bit more depth. So first question. So your name's Aiden.
Yeah.
Tell us a bit about yourself.
So, the things that they were talking about, like things that I've gone through in my life, stuff like that, it's to do with my health, personal health issues, and you know, from a young age, I was born with an illness, which was kidney failure stage 2, which aggressively got worse as I got older. So, I hit around 18, 19 and I had a kidney transplant which then didn't work, it rejected and failed. So now I'm having hemodialysis treatment for my illness which basically keeps me alive. So yeah, I'm born and raised in Birmingham, in Albury, Smethwick areas. Next question.
Birmingham lad, yeah?
Yes, yeah.
So another question for you, Aiden, is, so you're going through stage 2 kidney failure. So what sort of treatment do you have to try and help you with this?
Well, at the moment I'm having hemodialysis treatment. That is an end stage treatment now. Like
What do you mean by end stage?
End stage is when there's really nothing else that they can do and they're just keeping the person alive with the hemodialysis treatment. In my sort of circumstances with my illness, it is hemodialysis that that is, you know, given to us as treatment. So I have to go there 3 times a week on Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday mornings. You get hooked up to a machine and they put 2 big lines into your arm or your chest or your groin. For me, it's my arm. I had a small operation before I started dialysis. I had a small operation and what they do with that is they connect the main vein and the main artery together and form like a tunnel, like a channel. So they put 2 needles in, an in and an out. So what that is they take the blood out and then it goes round the machine, gets cleaned, all the toxins and all the poisons that build up in a kidney patient's body gets cleaned out, taken out and then puts back in through the inline. You know, sounds simple but it's a very tedious sort of procedure to go through. I mean, me myself, I'm having heart issues every time I have the treatment. You know, I'm not very well afterwards. I'm having issues even the day after. So it's a very long sort of procedure to go through, really.
One thing he told me in the day was, what is your dream? Like you said, you told me something about the end of
Oh yeah. He asked me earlier on, like, what is your biggest dream for your life? Like, what is the biggest dream? And my biggest dream, honestly, people will say, oh, I want to have this much money. I want to have this job, or this car. Do you know what I mean? But for me, guys, it is just solely having a normal life, leading a normal life, not having to go for these treatments, not having to go through pains or heart issues and things like that. So really mine is to just lead a normal life without all this, you know, dark clouds over me.
Yeah, that's brilliant. Just like what he just said, his dream is for this illness that he's got to go.
Mm-hmm.
God has made us not perfect, and a lot of us are ill, and a lot of us are okay. And this is one of the reasons why we should get together and talk about this, so we can help people that are going through such trauma and such and difficulties. Because some of us, like me and Khalid, are lucky to be in good conditions. But now it's I truly believe that it's our responsibility to help brothers like Aiden. So nothing else that I can say. Anything else you want to say, Khalid?
Nope. It's upsetting for me because obviously we're fine, but then there's people out there that are not, and I've got like a soft spot for people like that. Like, I don't like people being ill, I don't like people being unwell or hurt, and just makes me a bit emotional. So it's a touching subject for me because I've got my own experience of stuff happening within my family, so it's like a soft spot for me. But yeah, it is what it is.
Is what it is, young grasshopper.
Yeah. So yeah, that's it. I also request that you guys please pray for my brother Aiden. Yeah, du'as, prayers, keep him in your prayers as much as you can so that he gets better, and hopefully the treatment that he's waiting to get finally cures him. So again, pray for him, please.
So we've spent a bit of time with our new friend here, Aiden. And he's very positive in his outlook on life. You would never guess that. You would never guess that he's suffering or going through a struggle in his life in terms of his illness. So my next question: how do you stay so positive?
What I do is, firstly, I surround myself with positive people. Two of them right here. So. Key is to surround yourself with positive people, really. And then secondly, I'd say get active, do things on a daily basis. Don't shut yourself away and, you know, let everything get on top of you, because that's not the right way to go about it. That's certainly what I didn't do. Keep yourself active, go out there, do things, set yourself targets, and, you know, things will look a lot brighter.
Well,
next, you got a question?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, take it away.
I've been waiting a long time for this, to actually meet someone that's going through something that I don't think I myself or Snapback Fitness can go through in our life. A question that I've always wanted to ask you is, because you've gone through so much in your life, do you have goals? What's your goal?
It is a good question. And I'd say my main goal really in life is I want to help others, not just people like myself with the same illness. I want to help other people that are going through similar but at the same different things, different illnesses, different problems, people that, you know, just face things on a daily basis. One of my other goals, as I said to these guys earlier, is to hopefully write a book.
Wow,
that is really good, isn't it?
Yeah, so that is one of them, is to write a book.
Yeah, a book is a really, really big thing. Wow, so how long, where do you see yourself doing the book? How long?
When can we see a book early published?
Yeah, where is it published?
From Mr. Aiden.
Yeah.
Well, I haven't, obviously it's not set in stone, that is just something that I'm thinking about doing in my head, because I think I've got the right things, the right attributes about me to actually go ahead and do that, so look out, It will be coming, hopefully. Don't know when, but it will.
It'll be on Apple Bookstore.
Oh, yeah.
Check it out.
just want to say a quick thing. A lot of you that are watching this right now, if whatever you're going through, how hard life gets, check out Aidan. He's going through the worst of the worst, and he's still standing here, smiling, and telling you guys never to give up. Because no matter how bad your worst days are, just through a smile, that alone can change the world and society in everyone's life. So again, Khalid, thoughts of the question?
Just to add on to what Limitless Mod just said, and what Aidan said earlier, surrounding yourself with positive people. If you feel like you know someone who's going through something, don't be afraid to just say, just ask them how they're doing. I mean, that could make such a big difference in their day and make them push further and better to try and, you know, get out of whatever they're going through. Just to give you a bit of background, how we met Aidan, just through Facebook. Aidan messaged me, and then we just started talking from there and messaging each other every day, asking him how he's doing, and he's telling me about his treatment and what he's going through himself, and I've just been there to just kind of listen to him. And I guess that in itself just has brought on this like little relationship we've got going on, to a point where we can sit here and have an interview and get to know him even more better. So yeah.
And to add on to what these guys have both just said, you know, sometimes when you go through things, I'm talking direct to people that are watching this that may have things going on in their life, sometimes you find yourself in some of the most deepest, darkest holes that sometimes you struggle to get out of, or you can't actually come to terms with how your life has changed suddenly and things like that. But in order to get out of these situations, you need to first accept it, then look at ways of distracting your mind from overthinking these situations, and then slowly, slowly, you'll see the light and you'll come out of it.
Yeah,
the other side.
Wow. That's amazing.
Very good advice. Another question is, what do you do in your spare time?
My spare time, could be through anything really. I like to just go out places, see new places, and, you know, because as I said to people out there, get yourself active, go out there. I like to go swimming.
Wow.
Swimming, walking, go for walks, jogging and things like that.
That's amazing, that is.
So yeah, my spare time is...
Brilliant. Just want to top that up, another question for yourself. If there's anybody out there that is going through a similar problem in terms of going to treatments or going to a hospital and you feel alone, what would you say and what would you can do to support them and in any way? What would you think? What can be done?
I know a lot of people, from having this illness and going to these treatments, you meet a lot of different people with a lot of different personalities. Perhaps sometimes somebody might not be as talkative as you are, or not as outgoing as you are, but sometimes you meet that odd person that is just like you, and they're easier to get along with and to guide and help through these things. But really, to answer Modgie's question, help and advice for you guys, just don't shut yourselves away. It might seem like a dark place that you're in, it might seem like a long, far shot that you know, to getting better, road to recovery, or as we like to call it, endless journey.
endless journey.
So, you know, just don't shut yourselves away. Just find people to talk to. If you find that you can't talk to, because me myself, I find that I can't talk to my family. I don't like doing it because I don't want to hurt them with everything that I'm going through. So that's where, you know, other people come in, like friends, or, you know, just people that are positive again and will listen.
Brilliant. So, anything you'd like to say, Snapback Fitness?
Well, that to me is just so motivational. I mean, he's gone through so much stuff in his life, and if only I can put it into words, that how it makes me want to do so much better. It gives me so much motivation to go out there and chase my dream.
Wow.
Which is what my man over there always says, go out there and chase your dream.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's really good I really love the positivity that you're spreading out.
Come to the end now. I just want to say that, like I said, we've done this, we've arranged this, and we've only done this for the sole pleasure of letting you guys know about what is Aidan's going through and what his life is about. And because a lot of people don't know about Aidan and what he's going through, and now that he's got it out there to you guys, he's given the opportunity for you guys to know what he's going through. If you've got anything to say to us, just leave a comment, get to us. If there's anybody out there, if you're going through anything, we can make a video for people to know about what you're going through, because that's what we're here for. We're here to help, we're here to guide, not just for ourselves, but as a community, as a whole, as a one family team. That's why we all go through our life journeys, but we thought we can do this together. So is there anything else you want to join on to that, Khalid?
Well, that was quite moving. That was got me right there. No. I don't know what else to say to that. That's pretty much everything.
Anything? Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know, last of all, just gonna wrap up with saying that, you know, these guys have been a huge, huge support to me, like right from the start. They've been a huge support. Oh, stop it. But no, seriously, they have. They've been a huge support to me. They're fabulous guys, and what they're doing already with their own things and that, I just think they're amazing, personally.
Nah, please. We're not. Listen, just to say that we are ordinary people, and there's a lot of talented, great people out there that are so quiet. And by working together and meeting new people, it's just amazing. Words can't explain how we are, you know, getting family. These are my brothers now, you know what I mean? I was lonely, now I've got brothers to look up to speak to for any problems that I got to. I can come to these guys. So again, to finish it off, everybody out there, we kindly request that you share this out to everybody that you know of, to help people like Aidan and even myself.
Yeah, true. So like, and share, comment, subscribe. Arms Not Back Fitness.
Live Limitless Mind with
Aidan.
Our boy Aidan. And looking forward to seeing you guys again and another endless journey with our boy Aidan.
Our journey may be endless, but it ain't over.
So peace. Oh, look at the load of us.
Hey.
Hold on. Do you know about this? Loads of us.
This is like Bruce Lee.
Yo, boy, do you know about this? Dragon rips his tail. Tack, tack.
Okay.